Just to verify before we begin, these are the minimum requirements to be able to use Ethernet IP with a Productivity Series CPU. To set up implicit Ethernet IP messaging, you will need this assembly instance information. This information is what is used to point to the correct memory location and the amount of data that is contained there. Now, this data is split into the input data block and the output data block. So the input data is what we're reading from the Stride switch, and the output data is what we're writing to the switch. These tables define the input and output data block mapping. All this information can be found in Appendix E of the Stride SE2 User Manual, and we will be referring to them later in this video. So to make this connection, open up the productivity project you will be using. Double-click on the hardware configuration, and then select the Ethernet IP tab from the top. Now drag the generic client from the right into the gray area. You can place an individual tag for all of these elements, or you can check the box Use Structure. This will create a structure of tags that can be used for this device, make it a lot easier on the programmer to create, use, and find the correct tags. It will really make your process a lot easier. So I'm going to select the Use Structure and give it the following name. Now you'll need to give your device a name. Type in the IP address of the switch. The TCP port number for the switch will be 44818. Click on the green cross and select Add I/O Messaging. These tags will also be part of the original structure created above. Now this tag in particular will become important later. When it is enabled, it will start the reads and writes to the data block at the RPI that we select. Here you see that there are now three tabs. Let's start with the input data block. From this information, we see the assembly instance should be 101. Now this array portion is what catches some. The data array data type that we use here must match the data size of the input data blocks. The size of the input data block is in bytes, and there are 156 of them total. So we need to create a data array of an 8-bit type, which matches the bytes, and has at least 156 columns. So type in the name of the data block you want to create, and when you try to select the number of elements, you'll then be asked to create this array. Change the data type to 8-bit unsigned, and increase the number of columns to 156. Select OK, and then increase the number of elements to 156. Now select the Output tab. The assembly instance is 102. I'm going to name my output data array as the following, and when I select the number of elements, I'll be asked to create the array. Change the data type to 8-bit unsigned, and the column size to 20. Click OK. Now change the number of elements to be 20. On the configuration word, all we need to do is uncheck this enable box. That completes the client setup to the switch. When we select OK here, we'll be completing the structure for the Ethernet IP client. Since this communication is handled by the client, there is no need for any ladder code. So transfer the project to the CPU, and with the PLC in run, let's open up the data view. Enter in the enable tag from the Ethernet IP client structure, check the edit box, and send the edit to the CPU. That is all you will need to do to get these devices to talk to one another. So let's check the status on the switch ports. So place the input data array into the data view, and this will need to be viewed as binary for this to make sense. From the input map, we see that port 1 status is the most 2 significant bits. The next 2 bits would be for port 2, the next for 3, and so on. Now I have a device connected to port 1, and that shows correct as the bit pattern is 01. Now if I remove that cable from port 1, I get 10. Now if this port was disabled, I would receive 00. If you have any questions about using this Ethernet managed switch or any of our products, please contact Automation Direct's free, award-winning support team during regular business hours. They will be happy to help. Click here to learn more about Automation Direct's many support options. Click here to learn or see more videos on the Stride switches. And be sure to click here to subscribe to our YouTube channel.